So I'm delighted to announce BetAngel version 151. We've made a significant number of changes within version 151, and it's just another on the path of all the upgrades that we do over a long period of time. We love to introduce new features. We love to listen to feedback from our customers about what they want. You've got some very big customers that trade on Betfair using BetAngel, so we're always interested in hearing how we can improve the product for them. But also, of course, you know, it's vitally important for me as well. I'm utterly reliant upon BetAngel. I couldn't do any of the things that I do without the product, and it allows me and you to maintain your edge or gain an edge within the market. We've always invested heavily in BetAngel. You've got to remember that when BetAngel was created, there were no traders en masse. Betfair didn't have an API. It was created purely for trading. There was no commercial opportunity for trading software back then, and that's why it was created. And that's how we intend to continue to invest going forward. We want you and us to maintain our edge in the market and grow as much as we possibly can. So we're going to keep plowing as much money as we can back into the software to continue to develop it. And what's changed in version 151? Well, there are significant amounts that have changed, so much so that I'm not going to throw it all at you in one video. It's going to take a few videos to be able to demonstrate all of the key changes that we've made. And I'm not going to do it all in one video or all in one week. I'll probably spread it out a bit and introduce you to new features so you can understand properly how to use them. But on this particular video, we're going to focus on one particular enhancement that we've made. And in fact, even that is probably going to take two or three videos. I'm doing this sort of ad hoc to walk you through the main features that we've done. So I imagine, knowing what's within it, that I may have to break out into a couple of videos at least, maybe three, to show you to its full extent exactly what we've achieved with this product. But what I need to do first of all is actually appraise your knowledge of the product anyway, by looking at some older features so you can understand what we've done and why. So if we go to the top left of the screen and we look at the view area, this contains the screen layouts. So the screen layouts are there for you to rearrange the screen however you wish. So you could put something over here, something up there, if you've got multiple monitors, or maybe put loads of stuff on one screen, carefully organize and arrange it. And then you save that layout so that at the click of a button, you've got all of that layout back exactly the way that you want it. So you fire up BetAngel, rearrange the screen however you want, save that layout, and then maybe you do a different layout for different sports or different markets or different strategies. But they're all available with just one click. Now, you can do screen layouts, but you can also do individual settings as well. And that allows you an incredible amount of flexibility in terms of the way that you use the product. So if we look on the ladder display here, you can actually see that we actually have another settings area now, which are the ladder settings. So we have enhanced what you can do with the ladder and its flexibility significantly in BetAngel version 151. Let's have a look at some of those things. So if I click on the spanner next to the profile name here, and that gives you a clue about one of the things that you do. I'll walk you through these towards the end of the video, but can you see we've put some examples in there for you to play with. But let's have a look at the settings editor so you can understand what's going on within here. The general tab is what you would have seen before in BetAngel. It allows you to switch on and off certain features such as the trading profit column and modify elements of the ladder display. You can display more ladders across multiple rows. You can actually display, I don't know if you know this, 18 ladders in one go if you want, and you can also display them across multiple rows. You may want to have a fiddle with that, it can be quite fun. But for a greyhound race, you can have six ladders, a row of 3x2 or 3x1, 6x1, whatever you want to do. But yeah, this is a feature that, or these features are in previous versions of BetAngel, so I'm not going to labor on about these. If you click on columns, you can modify all of the columns. Incidentally, and you'll see this as we walk your way through version 151 and why we've done it, we've actually changed the color picker so that you've got a wider range of colors. May not make sense to you at this particular moment in time, but I guarantee it will when you see all of the features that we've got within BetAngel version 151. Charts. Now, if we look at charts, on the right-hand side here, which I think is probably over there, but I apologize for confusing you if it's in the other corner. So I'm just going to say advanced charts. Look at the advanced and enhanced charts. The enhanced chart on the ladder you can display on the right-hand side by clicking on the lightning bolt. So you can see that's how the advanced chart pops up. But you can see here, you can modify a couple of different areas here, but on this version, we've made it really simple to display them just below the ladder. So you can actually decide what type of chart that you actually want displayed directly on the ladder. You don't have to undock and move stuff around any longer. But you can also display the advanced chart, so you don't have to have it on the right-hand side. You can actually have it underneath the ladder if you so wished to do so. But you could actually change its position as well, but we'll come on to that in a minute. But to edit the individual advanced charts, click on here. You can select whichever advanced chart you want to use from here, and you can change the edit. I'm not going to go into how you can modify the advanced chart, but you can display anything, technical indicators, all sorts of weird and wonderful things. We have an advanced charting mega video that you may want to watch. It's 30 minutes long. That's how many features there are on the charts. Not going to cover it in this video. But basically, what you can see here is you can display charts directly in line on the ladder. You can modify the position. Talk about that in a minute. Now, the unmatched bet area is one of the areas that I know I'm going to have to do a separate video on, because typically the way that unmatched bets have been handled on the ladder before have been fairly standard, but we've significantly enhanced this. There are some key benefits to the way that we've enhanced this, though it deserves a separate video so that you can get a full understanding of exactly what we've done here and why. So I am going to park that and move it on to a separate video. But you can see here, you can show unmatched bets in the same column. You can show them in the odds column. You can apply a colored background for unmatched bets, but you can also modify the behavior of the mouse on unmatched bets within the market. You can modify what happens when you single click, when you double click on the left and the right hand side mouse button. They all do different things. It's pretty amazing. And I'll do a separate video on that to explain why we've done that and probably what you would like to use that for, how it will enhance your trading. So I'll do that on a separate video. I think that's worthwhile. Otherwise, this would be an incredibly long video. You can also see, and I did touch on this in a previous video, how you display or highlight unmatched bets. But again, you know, I'll cover that in a separate video. Now, an area that you wouldn't be expecting that we have put within here is an additional information area. So the idea of this is that on the ladder, you can actually display additional information at different areas of the ladder. Why would you want to do that? Well, it could be that you just want to display the jockey name or other information within there. We've had requests for that, so we thought, well, why not just make it completely custom definable what you wanted to put in there. But if we actually look at additional information, the preset information, you can see you can display all sorts of stuff here. SP, highest traded price, lowest traded price, other information can be displayed within the additional information area. And you can also modify its color, font size, the alignment, its position on a horizontal bet, all those sort of that you would expect if you want to carefully define something. But where it gets really powerful is you can actually display stored values as well. So you can actually get BetAngel either via a servant or automation to go off, find information for you about the market and display it right on the ladder in front of you. That makes, you know, if you're looking for something specific in the market, get BetAngel to go off and look at it and get it to alert you on the ladder when it finds it. It's really, really helpful. I've been using this for about a month or so, and it's immense because all of the stuff that you could be looking around the screen on is suddenly presented for you right in front of your very eyes. Not only that, it can self-modify itself. It's amazing because you can get the automation to look for something saying, I'm looking for this, this and that, and then it goes, jung, and displays it in front of you on the ladder for you to act on immediately. Or say you're in a trade and something is changing somewhere else, or the market's shifting somewhere or another, it can display that on the ladder. But it's almost infinite what you can display now that you have stored values in there. But yeah, you can display preset information, stored values, and you can actually layer it as well. You can see over here, we can actually put in a number of different rows. So we can just put more and more information on the ladder depending upon what you want to see within there. Very powerful tool. It's probably worth me putting this into another video and putting a few examples together. But you can have a good play with it. I mean, I suggest when you get a new version of BetAngel, stick it into practice mode for a bit and just get used to all of the features and functionality before you start trading with it. But we don't do these upgrades lightly. We all do it because we think it will enhance your trading one way or another. So yeah, a very powerful feature. Additional information can be displayed within the ladder. I'll show you in a second a really basic implementation of this. Now, what you can also do on the ladder, which is a significant enhancement on this version, is you can modify the way that the ladder looks. So you can modify it vertically or horizontally. So, for example, we've got the staking at the top of the screen here. Perhaps you don't like the staking at the top of the screen. Perhaps you like it at the bottom or somewhere else. You could put it above or below. You can move stuff up and down. So you can see we've got the advanced chart down here. So if we wanted to move the advanced chart up, we could do that. I'm not saying that you would necessarily want to do that, but it's perfectly possible to do that if you so wish. I've got a really basic advanced chart on here. It doesn't show off actually what you can do, because the chart that we've got on the right hand side, you can display along the bottom as well. And that's really the one I should have put there. But I'm not going to re-record the video, but you understand where I'm coming from here, hopefully. You can put whatever advanced chart you like down there, and you can display it wherever you want, at the top, at the bottom, however you want to display it. But you can also move the ladder columns around as well. So say, for example, we wanted to put the odds, which are in the center at the moment, and we wanted to shift them over to one side. You can see that's very easy to do, or you can shift them back in the other direction, or you can just put them back to where they are in the center. Or maybe you want the back and lay prices together. You know, that may give you an edge because it will allow you to see a gap within the market very easily. But it's up to you how you want to use that functionality. But basically, you can modify the ladder by raising elements or lowering elements vertically, but you can also move columns horizontally as well. So you've got an immense amount of flexibility within there. The enhanced area, it basically refers to what's going on the right hand side. So you don't have to modify that at all, but obviously that's included within the ladder settings as well. Once you've got everything set up exactly the way that, in fact, it's annoying me that we've got that ladder there. So I think I've got, maybe I need to modify that anyway. So, but you can see you may have to create a new chart that you would necessarily want to display at the bottom, because it may be a little bit compressed. But of course you could go in and say, well, actually I want that to be a lot bigger. So you can basically see where I'm coming from here. There are lots of modifications that you can make. And once you're happy with what you've done, you can just use the save as area to do my amazing ladder settings. Although I suspect you would probably call it football, tennis, you know, however you want, in play racing or something like that. And once you save that, then that immediately becomes available from within the drop down box over here. So you can see we've got my amazing ladder settings at the bottom, but we have also included for you some defaults. So this is, you can see I tend to use quite large cell heights, but you can use smaller ones if you want to get more odds on the screen if you feel more comfortable. Betfair charts at the bottom. If you look at this, you can see the screen moved slightly from here. Betfair charts at the bottom, I move down. And if you look at the top here, we've displayed additional information. We've got the jockey and the trainer. So if there's a gamble going on, you should be able to spot it fairly easily at the top. You can see that what we've done on this one as well is the bets are displayed in one column. Again, I'm going to have to talk to you about what that does and why. But basically what I'm trying to show you here is some of the presets that you've got. You can have a look at the presets, go in, edit them, modify them to suit. But it's up to you how you want to use all of that. But editing them and saving them will allow you to play around with individual settings. We've got the tick charts here, or the last traded price charts, depending upon what you want to call those. A very, very compressed ladder here. Compressed ladder with Betfair chart. There's an infinite number of varieties. So the reason we've put these examples in there is for you to have a good old play around with them, basically. And then you can edit them to suit however you wish to use them. So yeah, this is just one of the features that we've got, or the additional features we've added to BetAngel version 151. There's a lot more of depth within the product and the additional features that we've got. Like I said, I'm not going to do them all at once, but I'll gradually talk you through all of them over the coming weeks. But if you want to download a copy of BetAngel version 151, head on over to the forum where we've put BetAngel version 151. And we're taking some feedback here where we can modify or add a couple of elements that you so wish before we put it on full release. But yeah, the whole idea is to improve your trading, improve on this particular feature, the flexibility and customization of what you can do on the ladder interface. And also through the addition of things like additional information, excuse the double use of the word additional there, that will allow you to significantly enhance your trading and pull information into the ladder, which you can then trade off of. So yeah, for starters, there's one of the key changes that we've made in BetAngel version 151.